Hi everyone and welcome to my place. Today I'm here to help Julia from the UK, and she said to me that she had seen my lime wash that I had, or my chalk paint that I had done, and she said to me, is there anything that you can do with it other than tinting it up? Well, there's lots of things that you can do with it, so let's just brush over that what you can do with a lime wash paint or a chalk paint. Now, you can get it from Porter's Paint, which is a fantastic paint, and it comes already tinted up and ready to go, but not always can you get it. And you know, lots of times when I'm doing something, I want it right now. Well, I have my own chalk recipe paint that I use, and it's a cup to every cup of undercoat white paint, I add 3 tablespoons of plaster of Paris mixed to a paste with a little warm water, mixed, and just let it sit for a couple of hours. Now it comes white and looks milky like this. Now you can use chalk pigments, you can use fruits, berries, vegetables, whatever you want to tint it up, or you can just buy a test pot and just add that to it. But the secret is to use, like I used to like to use, an undercoat, but fantastic stuff. You don't have to undercoat it, you don't have to do anything. Once it's on any surface, you're ready to go. Right, now, here is the pot, this grey pot I'm going to paint, and it's a terracotta paint pot that's already been painted grey, but it's a really nice shaped urn to be using. So that's the grey, and what I have done is I have put 2 coats of my chalk paint, or you can use Porter's, whichever you want. The great thing with Porter's is it's all ready to go, and they're all beautiful, beautiful old worldy chalky colours, which are just fabulous. Now from here, Julia wants to know what else you can do with it. She's heard about lovely waxes you can get. Right, well, from here you can either leave it as it is, and I'll show you some of the things that I like to do with it. Because it was grey to start with, what you can do is you can just get a piece of sandpaper and you can just like sand away around the edges, exposing to get the paint from underneath to come through, which can give it that lovely old sort of like aged look like I've done here. Or what you can do is what I have done with this one here, which was exactly like this one here. So I've just scored around the side there, or sanded that back with a little bit of fine sandpaper. But to get this effect here, what I've done is I've used a lovely brown wax over the top of it. Really, really lovely to use and to work with. And it's just a matter of, and I'm using an Annie Sloan's one here because that was all I had. It's a wee test pot that she gave me when she was here in New Zealand not so long ago. But you put this on with a paintbrush like this. I did have a beautiful paintbrush until somebody got hold of it. But when you're putting the lime wash onto it, or the chalk paint onto it, when you put it on, you put one coat on and really, really like crisscross it on, and then do the next time you put the coat on, go the other way. And it's just a matter, and when you do that, you can see where the brush has been, and you get this lovely sort of like crisscross hatched effect like so. Just put that on there like that, let it dry for a few moments, and then get your cloth and just buff it up like I've done. Just buff that up like so until you get the desired effect. You might like to add more paint, more wax, until you get it to the consistency or the darkness that you want to, which is what I have done with this one here. So once that's dry, you just go over it, get a nice clean cloth, and just go over it and give it a really beautiful buff up. And I just love how it just goes into the areas where you've been a bit rough. Now the other thing you can do is you can do it like that, and then once you get to that stage, just go round with your sandpaper again and get rid of as much. If you want it to look a little bit more aged and vintage, just get into there and just give it a good scrub up until you get it to the effect that you want. You can get it in the brown wax and you can get it in a clear wax. And the other thing that you can do is you could do 2 to 3 coats of different colours, wax it up, and then buff it back or sand it back to get the effect that you want. How easy is that to get a grey, boring old pot to something that looks like that? I hope I have answered your questions, Julia, and I will see you all another day.